tasked with nothing less than the rebuilding of America. Such a huge responsibility. Just know that Vault-Tec is proud of you. I am proud of you. When you hear this, it means I've been gone for several hours. I've got my own mission out there in Appalachia. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Mr. Cole! Hello? Oh, finally! I feared you'd never wake up. Don't you remember? It's reclamation day. Time to leave the vault. Most of the others have already gone. Best get cracking. Of water out there, almost all of it undoubtedly irradiated. When in doubt, boil it out. Be on constant alert for the clickety-click of your Pip-Boy's built-in radiation meter. This warm, secure vault for a hostile wilderness with no running water or electricity. Teamwork. It's what built America.
Overseer's log, or should I say, direct communication. Because whoever is listening to this had the moxie to try to find out where I've gone. But I'm glad you did. Truth is, I need your help. I've been given a task and I've decided to break protocol and tell you what it is. Because if there's one thing I've learned in these past few years, it's that we need to rely on each other. There were three active nuclear silos in Appalachia before the bombs fell. They blew up the world before. We can't let it happen again. So we've got to locate and secure all of the silos. Or die trying. Hopefully the former. But it's been 25 years. I just don't know what we're gonna find out there. Or where to start. My directive was to go to the nearest population center and assess the situation. I'll set up a camp on the way once I get my bearings. Find me there.
instrumental to the rebuilding of America. One tetanus-inducing rusty shack at a time. Some may call them jobs, but I like to think of them as perks. Goodbye! Aloha! Ciao! Arrivederci! Au revoir! Auf Wiedersehen! Vaya con Dios! Buen viaje! They grow up so fast. Happy Reclamation Day! Now go get 'em! The overseer said she'd set up her camp down the road to the south. You should head to that camp. Find the overseer.
There's more.
Vault 76. I knew this wasn't going to be the Appalachia I remembered, but mutated animals, haywire bots, and no people so far. have to be ready to rebuild in what I can confirm is hostile territory. Fortunately, Vault Tech was prepared. You see this? The cooking station, the stash box, the workbenches, all built with the camp. You need a home to camp. The construction and assembly mobile platform is designed to give you one. Just add resources, planning, and a little elbow grease. When you move your camp, everything you've built is stored, ready to be placed back down in the new area. Use this to establish a foothold whenever you're in unfamiliar territory. I've left my camp behind so you can use it. I know I'm breaking my own advice by not taking it with me. But after seeing Appalachia for myself, I need to make sure every resident of 76 has a safe haven they can start from. I'll make do without it. If it's still standing, the town of Flatwoods is further down this road. Find me there. This is the Overseer, signing off.
hostile target identified.
Scanning. Acceptable levels of compostable material.
Automated warning to all responders. The Mr. Fanhands are out of control. Evacuate civilians. And take down those supervisors. Once they're dealt with, you'll have to reboot the server. Again. Automated warning to all responders. The Mr. Farmhands are out of control. Evacuate civilians. And take down those supervisors. Once they're dealt with, you'll have to reboot the server. Again.
Overseer's log. Town of Flatwoods. My God. There's no one here. The old tavern, the church. People were using them for shelter, but they're gone. Mutations we expected. But there's something else. A disease. I was attacked by... Well, it used to be a person. But it had these green, glowing lesions, and its voice. Angry. Tortured. We are one. But what? Whatever happened here, is beyond anything we expected. And we expected a lot. Before they were wiped out, the survivors called themselves the responders. Looks like they were made of firefighters, police, emergency medical staff. They even have an automated system to teach people about treating water, food, survival. I'm doing their tests, and you should too. I know it's even worse than we imagined, but... Someone's got to know where the missile silos are, and how to secure them. The responders are the best lead we have. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Welcome to Survivor Stories. I'm Dasa Ben Ami, a responder. I've been working with the responders
for several
years now.
It sure is great to see
I'm from Charleston
living.
Originally,
You'll
so it was easy to join up.
Again.
What wasn't easy was the work. Rebuilding Appalachia from the rubble while survivors flock to us regularly from all over. So many have come and gone. Their stories untold, their names lost to time. I thought we should preserve this history somehow. I've decided to ask people to record their thoughts, their stories, anything they want to preserve forever. I'll call this series the Survivor Stories. I'll start with me. I was an anthropology PhD student at Vault Tech University, final year. I was printing my thesis when I heard the sirens. I thought for sure my father, a Vault-Tec employee, could take us all with him, but only two reservations came through. I refused to go. With my little brother, went to the vault. They could not persuade me, though they tried. In the end, I pushed them inside it, and that was it. After that, I went back home to Charleston and, well, survived. Eventually, the responders formed, and I signed up right away. It was so hard. The flood was devastating. Relocating to Morgantown Airport and now Flatwoods has been... I remain optimistic. Been with them now for, I guess 2 years. We have big plans. So much to help. Maybe, just maybe, we can raise enough to be okay. And in the meantime, I will continue to record stories of survivors when I can. Here are your history. This is Dasa Ben Ami, signing off for now.
Hi. Dasa asked me if I would talk about, how I got here. She asked everybody, so I said okay. My name's Colonel, and I'm 13 years old. I just wanted to say I'm sorry. I'm sorry for everything. The bombs and the messed up people and the cows with two heads, all of it. I was bad. Bad. I cheated on my spelling test. I kicked Chip Wilkins in the shins until he cried. I pushed Rosie McCloy down the stairs. I cut holes in the bottom of all the gym shorts and put glue in the mashed potatoes in the cafeteria. I told Harold Newell to eat 10 dead flies a day in order to grow muscles, and I put new Coca-Cola in the rat cage water bottles at the pet store. And I just wanted to say I'm sorry about everything. My dad said if I wasn't this way, the bad things wouldn't happen. I haven't seen Daddy since the bombs, and I guess he left because of that, too. It's okay. I'm trying to be good now, though. I'm not old enough to be a volunteer, but Dasa said I could help collect food and water, so I'm getting better, I promise. And... Daddy, if you're listening, I promise I won't be bad anymore, so you can come back now.